Music Live, the name of the game. Here we are, our Christian Minson, Guanacaste State, Costa Rica, Rythmia Life Advancement Center. Welcome, folks. Just getting on. If you come on the recording, skip to 4 or 5 minutes in. Usually about 4 minutes, we get started with the content. Until then, we're just saying hi. Hello, everybody out there. A couple people joining on. If you join in, type in where you're from. Give me hearts. Give me thumbs ups. Tammy Scarlett, welcome. Let me hear from you. Petra Schwab, hey. Karen Erska, hey. All right. Some good names, some good people. Today, here we are. It's nice and sunny out, nice and warm. Going into the dry, warm season here. Come Christmas time, usually it gets a bit windy. That's a great time for transformation. Petra, hello. I know from Switzerland. Robert Bruce, hey, how you doing? Going to be in LA over Christmas. Patty, hello. And from Malibu, yeah. Like I said, I'll be in LA over the Christmas time, so if we can join up, that'd be cool. Heather. Aisha, wasn't I just talking with you? Hello, nice to see you on Facebook Live. And so we're just getting, let's see if we can break the record today. What are we at? We're 2 minutes in, 35 people coming in. Practice your hearts and likes skills there. There we go, some people, some faces, some, hello, Aisha. And Georgina, you're in Hawaii, right? Still, if you are still wanting to come visit you. Adrian, hey, thanks for the van concert. All right, Adrian, you got the best. Went home for the Thanksgiving holiday and actually took a travel guitar and we played all the way to the airport. So we played and sang. So that was a fun time. Georgina, I love you too. Aisha, hello again. Anthony, hey, all the way from Dubai. Hey, Anthony, check out Aisha above there. You are both in Dubai, so maybe there's a connection to be made there. Kevin, hello. And Justin, hello. Wendy from Whitstable in the UK. Welcome, welcome. All right, folks, good, here we are. I'll give it another minute and we'll get started. Justin, hello. And Luis, hello from Santa Cruz, Guanacaste. Hey, that's where we are. All right, so I'm gonna get started in just a minute. A few more hearts and likes if you wanna say, say hi, and good, you guys made the Dubai connection. That's great. Dela, hello, and 50 people, all right. We're going high today, 55. We got 5 seconds left, 58. Keep going, folks. Join on in, Robert Bruce, Christian, and the Shakti Love Goddess is that's definitely the Breathwork tribe there. Swiss in the house, Dela. So is Petra. Petra's from Switzerland, so say hi to her on here. Oh, wow, up to 80 people. All right, well, we're at 85 when I get started. Definitely a good number. We got a good crowd today. Somehow, these past few weeks, people are joining on in force, which I like to see. So welcome officially. My name is Christian Minson. I'm the director of the Breathwork Program here at Rythmia Life Advancement Center. I should say the outgoing director. I've been here for 2+ years, and my final day will be January 11th of the 2020. So sad to go, but happy to go too. You know, I say any parting should be half sad, half happy. Sad for all the things to be leaving, the family I've left here, the vibe that I have left feel like I've helped build this place, and then but on to bigger and better things in my own personal life, including possibly getting to Dubai, you Dubaians. I'm next time I'm in Rythmia, we will meet up hopefully. Yeah, Dayla. Lisa, hello. Hi, Petra. Good. You guys make the Swiss connection. So today I am talking on the subject, the name of the game. This is my chance to wax philosophical today, if you let me. I figure. Just speaking in terms of try some different ideas on what life is really all about, and from a particular perspective, a perspective that's come from, I've mentioned I'm the breathwork director here. I've been a breathworker, healer, holistic healer for the last 13 years. I was a monk before that for 10 years, a monk in a spiritual meditative order of Paramahansa Yogananda. Some of you may know him, Autobiography of a Yogi. And my philosophy of life and was really shaped by those years in the ashram, and interestingly too, by my medicine experiences that I've had not only here at Rythmia, but prior to becoming a monk years and years ago. So all this stuff, you know, confluences together to create what our topic really is today. So, you know, now I'm out there as an internet coach and a speaker and author, travel all over the world giving breathwork workshops and seminars, and basically I'm your catalyst for evolution and transformation. So welcome today. The topic, the name of the game, you know, and why are we talking about this? Hold on, let me just say hi. What's your TV website again? My site is breathflow.com, if you want to know that. Aloha from Northern California, say hi to a few of you guys. Hello. Like the nerdy guy Hollis there. So, so where am I? Why? Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. This is sort of the mandate of the United States of America. You know that we all have these inalienable rights for life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And what I've noticed in our society, at least Western American society, and I'd extend that to other Western and maybe even Eastern countries, is that we pursue happiness in a lot of wrong places. In other words, we pursue a lot of false happiness, things that promise happiness, and in the end end up just getting us into more trouble or feeling worse about ourselves or just dejected about life. So wouldn't it save a lot of time and heartache if we could understand the game we're playing and sort of the rules of engagement? And so this is I want to try on a philosophical framework for how life really operates. And you know, this is like traveling. Say you want to go from LA to New York, but you don't have a map, right? Well, you could end up going any which way. What if you went west? You'd end up in the Pacific Ocean. But if you actually had a map, if you had some kind of guide, some kind of direction, you'd say, all right, I take I-10 till I get to 15, cross Nevada to Las Vegas on the way through, maybe I-70, go through Denver, so on and so forth. You know where you're going. You got a clear direction. You're not wasting time going off on random tangents. And so this is really what I'm offering today, is a map, if you will, for this game of life and how we're playing it and what is important and what maybe isn't as a result. So Dale is saying, love the topic. Thanks, I appreciate it. It's time to transform. Excellent, Dale. Great. So what is the name of the game? The name of the game is, I forgot to mention too, guitar. If we got time at the end, we'll play a little guitar, a little song for you, as I've been doing the last Facebook Live. So hang in there till the end, all right? So what is the name of the game? The name of the game is self-realization. Self-realization. This, again, this really sunk in home in those years that I was a monk. This is what we're really pursuing. So what does this really mean, self-realization? It's the evolution of yourself, your little self, into your highest form, capital S. Your little S self, as I say, your little S self, turns into your big S self. And through an evolutionary process, this is the process of self-realization. The question is, what is the essence of you, this higher self of yours? And I would say that, in my philosophical framework, that the highest self, our highest self, is a unified field. That unified field is love. Love. The vibration of love is what I call the own vibration, the vibration of creation. It is the vibration that has brought forth into existence everything, including you as your little ass self. And now we're returning to the big ass self, which is love. So the evolution into your higher self or into love. This is the name of the game. What does it mean to evolve? To evolve, really, I would say the thrust of evolution is really to thrive in the abundance of that spirit of love. So the essence of our evolution is really to get a place of pure thriving, of being completely enthralled in the abundance of life and living life fully, balls to the wall, guns blazing, however you visualize it, that we are coming to greater and greater depths of thriving in this vibration of love. All right, so let go and become the truth, the true self. Beautiful. So this is the essence of self-realization, the essence of the game. The game, the name of the game is thriving in the essence of love, who the bigger S self. The practice then, to boil this down into practical terms, that the practice in life becomes the consistent practice of expressing love. Expressing love in all circumstances, okay? So this really equates to unconditional love. So the practice, life's soul practice, is the continuous expression of unconditional love, the expression of love in all situations, all right? This is love expressed for the sake of love, not for a result, not for something to come back to you. And this is a lesson that I continually learn, is that the joy in expressing unconditional love doesn't come from you catalyzing some love that's reflected back to you from an external source, usually somebody else. But the satisfaction, the joy of the expression of unconditional love comes in the act of expressing that unconditional love in and of itself, regardless of what it creates in your external environment, regardless of whether it gets reciprocated, regardless of whether it even lands. It is the expression of that unconditional love which is the joy, the satisfaction in and of itself. So I learned this recently, it confirmed it, let's say, recently. Taita Juanita was here last week, our rock star shaman. And so the first time since I've been here, I went through both of his ceremonies. Did the he usually comes for Wednesday and Thursday night. Wednesday night, I was in the ceremony, and I was deep in the medicine, and it I kind of realized that my mind generally jumps into a pessimistic track. It's like when nothing else is going on, it's like, what do? I start thinking, not that I'm overly depressed or negative or all that, but it's just like when the field is open, it's like I look at what could go wrong, what could be out of place, this really became glaringly apparent during this ceremony, because I was spiraling out a little bit. And then I just made this resolve. I said, well, what if I start thinking I'm in tune, I'm in love, I am whole, I'm complete. And the vibrational difference was so dramatic. It, of course, it was enhanced by the medicine, but from this place of pessimism to this place of optimism and just enjoying the love that was present in the moment. And it really just solidified in my consciousness even more that every moment it is a choice. We have a choice to be, to go down the track of pessimism, the track of darkness, the track of negativity, or we can choose the other track, positivity, optimism, love. So this is really it. It's about making this choice in every single moment. I remember when I was a monk, we were talking about the law of karma, and one of the monks said, karma is such a great law because it basically accounts for every single activity you ever do, every single action, from brushing your teeth to throwing the trash on the ground to, you know, being positive or negative in your relationships. You know, all of it is accounted for. And this is what we're saying here. When we're really talking about the expression of love, we're talking about that we really have to be vigilant to expressing it in every single moment of our lives. If we're not expressing love, we're expressing the opposite. And when I talk about every moment, I mean, when you wake up and you didn't get enough sleep, when your kids are late for school and you're trying to usher them out, when your partner misunderstands you, when the boss yells at you, when you're in traffic, when the doctor misplaces all your forms or makes you wait for 2 hours, you know, all these situations require as much expression of unconditional love as the ones where you're in harmony with somebody or you naturally get along or there's a natural joy that's there. And hello, Julie. How are you coming on? So we're making this choice in every moment. Now, this is the practice of unconditional love. Now, what's the field? The field in which we do this practice, we play this game, is really boils down to relationships. So relationships are the main field for evolution to take place. This is the field in which we practice the expression of unconditional love. And if you think about it, you don't really practice this when you're by yourself walking through nature. Now within reason, you can be in communion with the higher self and you can be expressing love. But this is a very internal process. Where the rubber meets the road, where unconditional love meets physical reality, is really through the interaction that happens in relationships. So again, this is, to me, why I'm bringing this out again today, I stated earlier, that if we have a map, if we really understand what the road is, what the purpose is, and what our ultimate objective is, it makes it very easy to make choices along the way. So if we know that mainly our work is done in relationship, we pay much more attention to those relationships. And a great relationship coach of mine would say that relationships aren't for being happy and fulfilled. They're about personal growth. And that's pretty much saying the same thing here. The relationships are the field through which we evolve, the field where we practice the art of self-realization, which is the art of learning to thrive in unconditional love. Justin, I'm evolving spiritually as well as we speak. I have a feeling it's going to be a big week for me at Rythmia in January. Justin, you could take that statement to the bank. I'd be willing to bet it's going to be a very big week for you here. So, all right, so that's the field, right? Then the tools, the primary tool that we use in order to communicate, to practice this unconditional love within relationships is communication. Right? Communication is the tool for making relationships work or not. Meaning if communication is working, the relationship generally is working. If it's not, the relationship doesn't. And so this can be words. Of course, communication happens in words. Communication happens in actions too. So the way that you act in relationship is a form of communication. So once again, here we are, we're looking at, you know, it's our, where our relationships are the field, which we're doing this practice of unconditional love. And the tool that we're really engaged with is communication. Karen, hey there, haven't seen you in a little while. Hi, Christian, always being accountable for our thoughts and actions is certainly the highest and best road for our journey. Thank you for your continued guidance. Love is the bridge. Right on. And Karen does a Spirituality Gone Wild podcast worth checking out. Anthony says, do you become empty if you are continually giving unconditional love? Do you need to recharge? That's a great question. And Sarah, who's our shaman here on Wednesday nights, which is the ceremony I typically go to because then we play some music at the end of the night with the guitar and all. She says, give out love. When you when you feel love, give it. As soon as much as you feel love, give it away. She said, and then you will see that it never diminishes. That the more that you give it, the more it gets replaced. So give that unconditional love. Now remember this, there's a difference between giving love truly unconditionally and giving love with some kind of expectation. If you find yourself burnt out from your efforts to give love and give love and give love, it's likely that you're doing it with the motive to receive something back, which isn't uncommon, all right? This is pretty much how life runs right now. But this is the most, perhaps, most vital turning point that we all have to make is recognizing that, you know, every time we give love with some kind of expectation for a return, we're setting ourselves up for a challenging existence. And the more that we give that unconditional love unconditionally, I mean, meaning we're not expecting some kind of return. If we get it, great, just more love to cultivate. If we don't, we're perfectly satisfied because it wasn't about what we're getting from the love, it was about the expression of that love in the first place. Right, so great question, Anthony, and hopefully that sort of answers that. Your life will completely change, Justin, talking to Justin. Anthony's saying, like, tapping into the big S to replenish the little S. Yeah, that's, you know, if we're operating from the little S self, then we will burn out. You'll start to feel a burnout. You'll start to feel, and, you know, working here, it forces you to learn quickly how to operate from the bigger S self, because again, if you're operating from a little S self, then you start to get tired, start to feel burnout. If you operate from that big S self, feel energized that, you know, you can give and give, and the next group comes in and you give and give more. So, so yes, and Dela says, hug Sarah for me. Definitely will do that every chance I get. So back to the the thrust of everything we're saying. Whoops, Justin, thank you. All right, it's a cross conversation here, so I won't get into it. All right, the practice, expressing unconditional love in all circumstances. The field is relationships. The tool is communication. And the main message that we communicate in relationships that keeps relationships harmonious and keeps love at the forefront is respect, okay? Respect is a great gauge of whether you're living in unconditional love or not. Both if you feel respect from your environment and if you don't, it's a good indication that perhaps that's not the environment that's really for you. You want to be, environment doesn't necessarily have to agree with you, right? Your environment doesn't have to be on the same page with you, but your environment needs to respect you. You have to feel respect from your environment, and the other way around too. Of course, your communication is about respect. The more that you can communicate respect to your relationships, the more unconditional love is expressed and is the field from which that relationship can grow. All right. So once again, here, it boils it down pretty succinctly. If you were to say what's the name of the game, it's communicate respect in every relationship that you come across, which equates to expressing unconditional love, which equates to evolving into from your little ass self to your big ass self, which equates to self-realization, the highest purpose and goal of life. All right, so to me, this is very helpful because now, anything you do, somebody cuts you off in traffic and you want to give them the that finger, or you know which finger I'm talking about, right? Does that communicate respect? In the field of that relationship, you and in this case a stranger, but there's still a relational connection there. Is that expressing unconditional love? I would say if I was doing it, no. That's that isn't an expression of unconditional love. So it gives me a gauge. Do I want to actually communicate that message to that person? Maybe I'm in full right. Maybe they did cut me off. Maybe they should have let me in and all that. But am I right or am I happy? Do I want to be right or do I want to be happy? And being right and telling them off and all that, this is the pursuit of happiness in a momentary sense. Maybe you feel relieved. You get this expression out. But then you tend to feel remorseful. There's always this negative-ish feeling because you put a wake of negativity out there. That action now, just like if you dropped a pebble in the water, the ripples of that action create this negative wake. And, maybe it's not such a huge wake. You can throw a small pebble in, but it still creates those ripples. Throw a big rock in and, it creates much more significant ripples, but still they're all creating those ripples, and enough of them come together, that's what amplifying is. Number of waves of negativity start to collect, and now we've got this big wave of negativity that rolls throughout the planet. So if we want to help neutralize that, we work towards that expression of unconditional love. So as I'm talking about this, if anybody wants to comment and say, like I said, this is it's more philosophical today. I'm not saying this is the gospel truth. I'm not saying that you should listen to me at all costs. I'm saying try it on. Feel into it. This is what feels right to me. And the more that I operate from this framework, the more confirmation I get that this indeed is the way life operates. But let's hear from you. If you think so, if you don't, if you got any questions about it, Petra's saying yes, and the same with self-love and a relationship with myself, respect, trust, and love. And that is, you know, one of the ways, the primary relationship is the relationship with yourself. So all this that I'm saying applies equally, if not more so, to your own relationship to yourself before it applies to relationship with others. I also believe that just our external world is simply a mirror or a reflection of everything that's going on in you internally. So if you like what's going on in your external world, you probably like yourself. If you don't like what's going on in your external world, there's parts of you that you don't like. And I dare say it, and that say even, you know, you like the politics that are going on. You like the wars that are going on. Do you like the abuses that are going on? If you don't like that stuff out in the world, it's really still a reflection of something deeper that's going on within you. That's beyond the scope of this talk today, but it's a topic worthy of going deeper. Ann Larson Rhodes, hi there. All right, so give me some feedback if any of you think anything about this topic at all. Adrian saying connecting through love is the way, and remember that the most important one to love is yourself. I hurt myself, I hurt others. I heal myself, I heal others. Very well put, Adrian. And that's the essence of what I'm saying. So while I am seeing if anybody else wants to comment and all that here, right now got some, a lot of cross conversations going on. Say some tips on expressing unconditional love. This again gives us a guide work. You know, we know that express respect through communication to relationships as the practice of unconditional love, which really creates self-realization or the name of the game. So things that are going to align us with deeper happiness, deeper satisfaction in all these channels is anything you do to focus on improving your relationships. So once again, you want to go to the football game or your partner wants to go to therapy and counseling, why not go to therapy and counseling? That's going to, even if you think maybe there's nothing to counsel about, see if that's going to create a greater bridge between you and that partner. That's a relationship building right there, right? Learning things from books, going to seminars. Anything to help you improve relationships is going to generally get you on the right track here. And really to give you, this is as much reminder to me as anybody's to put relationships above task. We've become a very, especially in the West, very task-oriented society. Where we often abuse relationships, quite literally often, but if not overtly, definitely subversively, that we give ourselves permission oftentimes to disregard relationships because the task is more important. And that is a critical flaw in the way that our society has developed these days. So it's important to replace, you know, the top dog relationship. How we relate to somebody is ultimately more important than what we're relating about, the task at hand. Still can be important, but not at the expense of the relationship. So then, let's see a few. How do you forgive somebody though? That's a great thing to come to Rythmia for. How do you forgive somebody? I'd say when you ultimately remember, first of all, that unconditional love is the expression of love in all circumstances. So that's whether you feel abused by somebody or not. And I've brought this story up many times before, but there's a woman in, came to this, to Rythmia. She'd suffered all the different kinds of abuse she could possibly have, sexual abuse, physical abuse, mental abuse, by family members, by close associates, by whoever, you name it. And at the end of one of the ceremonies, and we generally have time to share and express things, and she expressed, it's all love. She realized that it was all love. And, you know, recognizing that all of her experiences were just still an expression of love. And oftentimes, if you really get it, Michael Brown in the book, The Presence Process, talks about everybody's actions are really a subverted cry for unconditional love. They've just learned that love, they've learned to define love in a warped way based on their experience of people who weren't totally tuned in. And they pass that warped idea of love on. So every expression is somebody's cry for unconditional love. We really recognize that there's a lot more compassion to be had, and there's a lot more ability to forgive. The other thing to recognize when we're talking about forgiveness is the one that that benefits most from you forgiving is you, right? You are the greatest benefactor to you forgiving. Because who is, you know, so somebody wronged you, you think, or this is how you feel, maybe it's right. So you hold this grudge against them. Well, who's holding the grudge? That person out there is oblivious to this grudge. They're living their lives pure and free. You're sitting around here with this baggage, these rocks of grudge, and it's affecting your life. So when you forgive, you are actually releasing your hold on this bag of rocks, this grudge, and you are free. Doesn't matter what that other person, you know, is free to the extent that their karma will take care of things if truly there was a wrong created here or expressed. When you forgive, you are liberated. So hopefully that that helps give you some inspiration for forgiving, Christy. Great question, Dela. When love is the force and every intention love will be the outcome. Beautiful. Tom, hey, nice to see you on. All right. Petra, the fantastic is that when you give unconditional love, you get back so much more love out of the field. With this kind of love, we can make a difference in the world. And that's true too. Once again, you don't give unconditional love to expect to get back, but the reality is you do get back like 10 times more than what you put out there. The rub is that you don't usually get it back through the channel you're expecting. So you give out this love, you're expecting it to come back through the channel, especially of a person that you give, but it comes from the side and here, or from others that you didn't even realize that you affected in some way. But just like that ripple of negativity happens, so every pebble of unconditional love we throw into the pond ripples out. So we're creating these vibrations, and they're going off into the people we don't even realize maybe are affected by our actions. And this is how we get that love back. Jen, hello. Let you listen to your heart and knows the answer. Good weekend. Thank you, Daryl. Namaste. OG, hello. David, I often feel like I have high expectations of others. I don't know if I'm unrealistic. What's a good way to know? I would say, once again, judge by that respect gauge, David. People can make mistakes, but if they're making mistakes, but there's still a sense of respect there, that's it's important to give them some leeway to figure things out on their own. Of course, communication And you communicating respect back to them is going to help in that form. But but if there is a respect there and they make mistakes, you forgive them. But if the respect's not there, maybe that's when you say, well, those expectations, you know, those are baseline expectations. And if you can't communicate to them, that will cause a shift in their behavior to start operating from a baseline of respect, then maybe that's a good indication that those others no longer need to be in your field, or that you keep a respectful distance. And that's often what's meant by that. If you can't come together in respect, you keep a distance to where at least a distance respect is maintained. I want to know what love is. I want you to show me. Thanks, Justin. I'll let Lou Graham do that for you. But I will sing a song for you coming up here shortly. Forgive yourself, not others, and you'll be free. Thanks there, Petra. And Esther saying, it was great to meet you. And Basil with Greg, hope to visit you 2020. So Esther, Petra was at that gig too, so if you want to say hi to her. Shelly Albers joined. Hey, Shelly, nice to have you on. Just getting close to the end, so let's see what else I got to say. Before I end, just say, what if? What if you chose to recognize that the name of the game is self-realization? What if you chose to put on this framework? You know, that you know that that means that the purpose of life is to evolve into a thriving vibration of your higher self, which is ultimately unconditional love. All right, so if you knew this, if you operated from this framework, and that relationships were the field, that communication was your tool, that respect was the main thing to communicate every day, how much easier would it be to navigate the choices in your life? You know, the environments you get yourself into, the jobs you take, the relationships you choose to engage with, all these things would be so much easier to navigate when you have a gauge of whether they're aligning you with your higher self or not. And so this is really the purpose of today's talk, was to give you that idea that life could really be quite simple once we have a roadmap that kind of gives us direction. Karen says, 4 months after forgiving myself at Rythmia, I became open and able to receive the love from another in my intimate relationship. Now I'm able to give and receive the love and forgiveness continually. My relationship is incredible. Rythmia changed my life in more ways than I can count. Thank you again. Thank you, Karen. Beautiful to hear. And Justin, man, Christian, who am I going to sing with on Saturday night? I am bummed you're going to be gone the day I get there, January 12th. Well, hopefully we'll cross paths, so we'll at least get to sing a song. But thank you for your clarity, Christian. Thank you, Karina. And of course, if you like it, give me hearts and likes. If you don't like it, you know, give me a reverse argument. Not here to tell you that this is the way it is, just telling you, try this on for size, and if it fits, I can say that, once again, this has been wisdom that's come through my explorations with plant and other psychedelic medicines, my 10 years of monastic lifestyle, deep, disciplined, meditative lifestyle, my then 13 years as a breathwork facilitator and healer out there in the world. The last 2+ years here at Rythmia, going intensive in the helping people realm. So all of this experience basically has shaped this understanding. And what gives me a sense, like I said, this is something I couldn't give you any rational proof. This is how it all works, but it comes from a deeper intuitive sense. That as I've, and this is how I'd suggest you try out anything in your life, is give it a chance. You know, you hear something that sounds like it might be right, maybe it sounds a little hokey, maybe what? Give it a chance. Play it out in your life. Work with this framework for a while and see, does it align your life or does it throw you off balance? And if it throws you off balance, throw it away. It's not meant for you. And it could be, and it can work, that it can be for somebody, but not for somebody else, right? That's the paradox of this life, is that truth comes in all shapes, sizes, colors, flavors, and one flavor, shape, and size fits for one person, one flavor, shape, and size fits for another. And sometimes they can be diametrically opposed, which is why we so importantly need unconditional love, because sometimes we get confused that we're both fighting for the truth, and yet the ultimate truth is that it's not a fight, it's an embrace. So let's see, thanks Christian, thanks for you, Rythmia, my new life, Dela, beautiful. Thank you. See you very soon again. Are you coming before January 12th, Dela? So I'll get to see you. Adam, when you say respect, what do you mean by respect? Do I respect their soul, even though they might be doing things that I don't agree with? Yes, that's essentially what I mean. I think, like, you can not agree with somebody and you can attack them and say, you're wrong, you're bad, you're evil, you should be thrown in jail, blah, 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 whatever. Or you can say, you know, I respect who you are as a person. I respect that you are on a path just like I am, trying to figure things out. However, your actions are out of alignment. They're out of harmony with me, with that, you know, with this, blah, blah, blah. So the best way probably is to separate the person from the action. So can always respect the person as a fundamental expression of divinity. Every one of us is part of the whole. So every person out there is your brother or sister. Every person is really just a reflection of you. You don't respect them, once again, you don't respect something deep inside yourself. So you separate them from the action. So you can respect them, but you can decry their actions and say, hey, this is out of alignment, this isn't good for me or for the situation or for others. So hopefully that gives you a sense of that, Adam. All right, well, great questions, great things. So it's come to that time where we will play your little song. If that's something that's that you like, give me some hearts and likes now. Now this song, it's one we play here a bunch. I have not played it in ceremony yet, though I'd like to. We play the recording. hopefully I can sing it, because it's a little high. But let us try. Ready? Thank you. 15 comments since started there. Let's see what people say. Christian, you are amazing. Thank you. Love and light to all people. Good. To Justin, my favorite song, Christian. Thank you. Oh, Karen, you're welcome. Erska, one of my favorites. I know a few people whose favorites that is, including me. So weird you choose in dreams. I've been listening to that song all day. Seriously, son. Thanks, Justin. That is. And that choice just came in the last hour. So, Adam, feel the energy, Dela. To all of you out there, love. That gave me chills. Love you, Christian. Thanks, Justin, man. Touching. Jen, been playing this song on repeat all week. Here we go. We got a confluence here. We got something going on. Love that song. Tina, beautiful. JC, what's that song called? It's called In Dreams. I should have said before. In Dreams by Jaya Jagadesh, one of my favorite kirtan singers. I got to see her and hang out with her a little bit in San Diego a few years ago. So In Dreams, Justin put that in there too. Your voice goes right into my heart. Oh, thanks, Dela. Appreciate that, especially since this isn't as practiced as I'd like it to have been. Karen, listen to this tune several times every day since Rythmia was played last breathwork class I was in with you, my friend. I will always remember that loving message. Beautiful. Adam, cool. Adrian, thanks. Fiona joined, hey. Light and love, when you played it, I got flashbacks of ceremony. Beautiful, Adam. And Erska, I think, just put the link to that, the actual song, Jaya Jagadesh in Dreams. Everyone, it's been a real pleasure serving you here at Rythmia and here on Facebook Live every week. I got a few more to go with Rythmia, and then I'll keep up these Facebook Lives on my own. Of course, Rythmia will keep them up as well, with whoever is new and up and coming here. So remember the message here, unconditional love wins the day. Your expression of it through all your relationships and the communication in those relationships is paramount. Stay focused on that, and I guarantee your life will go 100% better. all right. Dun, dun, dun. Thank you. I won't see you when I'm there. Oh, that's too bad. Coming in February. Well, hopefully, if I don't see you guys here at Rythmia somewhere in this big blue marble, our paths will cross. I'm only going onwards and upwards on this path of self-realization, of expressing unconditional love and helping the world. So if that's your path, we are bound to meet somewhere along the way. That said, please sing again. We missed it. You'll have to, sorry, Anka, nice to see you on there. The recording will have it. I unfortunately have a call in 3 minutes that I have to get on. Yeah, thank you so much, Adam. That place in paradise. This place is a paradise. The food is good too. Yeah, so if you want to experience good food, good vibes, good people, great transformation, wonderful tasting plant medicine, and the comforts that only Rythmia can provide, this is the place. We're in the Alive Advancement Center. There's a number behind you. Come check it out. Whether I'm here or not, the place is amazing. So you come here. Keep you posted where you are. Yes, feel free to friend me on Facebook too if you want to do that. Daryl just said I sent a friend request. Include a message. Just say I saw you on Facebook Live, blah, blah, blah. So that will cause me to respond to that friend request. And that being said, all right, R. Christian Minson signing off for this week's Facebook Live. The name of the game, self-realization, evolution, and unconditional love. Yours in unconditional love. Until next week, namaste.